Barry Trebeth. And I'll be talking to Barry in just a moment about his career, his life, what he's doing, the things in his life that he had to overcome. But first, I'd like to play you a little drop of his music.
Say it's only a paper moon sailing over a cardboard sea, but it wouldn't be make-believe if you believed in me. Yes, it's only a canvas sky hanging over a muslin tree, but it wouldn't be make-believe if you believed in me. Without your love, it's a honky-tonk parade. Without your love, it's a melody played in a penny arcade. It's a Bonnie Mac Bailey world, just as phony as it can be. But it wouldn't be make-believe if you believed in me. Yeah, shoo-ba-diddin-diddin-do, shoo-ba-ba-diddin-do-do, shoo-ba-ba-diddin-diddin-diddin-do. Without your love, it's a honky-tonk parade. Without your love, it's a melody played in a penny arcade. It's a Bonnie Mac Bailey world, just as phony as it can be. But it wouldn't be make-believe if you believed in me.
There's a track from our next guest. It's 14 to 2 with some news coming up at 2 o'clock this afternoon. Nice to have you along too on the program, our second in this series of Showbiz. Barry Trembath is my next guest. He's a singer, a performer. Although in recent times he's had some personal health issues to deal with, he's always entertained. He's right back into it. He's gone from strength to strength. Barry is a graduate of the Victorian College of the Arts, and with more than 25 years' experience as an entertainer, he joins me now to say hello to you. Barry, welcome into Casey Radio.
Hi, Lee. How are you?
I'm well. I trust you're the same.
I am, yes. Thank you.
Lovely to talk to you, mate. We've talked online quite a lot. I followed your career and your songs and so on. What a marvellous voice you've got. That's lovely to hear all of that.
Thank you.
Really, really is. Tell me how it all started, Barry.
Oh, well, I started off as a dancer, obviously, because I went to the Victorian College of the Arts. But I always loved singing better. And so I went to the Victorian College of the Arts for 4 years, left in 1982, and then I went and did drama and dance at Box Hill TAFE. And then after that, because I was a dancer, I didn't really do much singing back then. I was in a dance company for 2 years, and then after that, worked at the Tivoli Theatre Restaurant for a few years.
I noticed the Tivoli Theatre Restaurant in your bio. That must have been a great experience. I used to love the Tivoli Restaurant. It was fantastic. I think it's still there, isn't it?
No, it's not, actually.
It's gone, is it?
It closed down about 2 years ago.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Okay. My wife and I would go there occasionally and really enjoy that, I suppose you say, vaudeville experience.
Yeah. It was great. It was fun. It was to do comedy as well as dancing and singing, you know. I never sort of really did much with it because I never had a lesson of singing, so...
Didn't you really?
No.
So what we've just played there on air, this is something that you've just fallen into, this song and dance.
I just love jazz. I've always loved Ella Fitzgerald.
Yeah.
And, so it's basically just been, you know, my love of music. I think I always wanted to be a singer instead of a dancer, so...
My guest before you was Marcia Hines, and I was saying to Marcia about who was her sort of was she forced into this sort of industry? Did she want to go and do it herself? And the answer was very, very much that this is something she wanted to do. Well, what about your background? Did your parents encourage you, push you, force you?
Yeah, my mum did.
Your mum encouraged you?
Yeah. She was all for it. Yeah.
She
used to take me along, and she still does.
It's a too
long to do shows.
Because of my
low vision.
Let's have a look at that for a second, because you had this problem some years ago, and it sort of put your career on hold for a while.
That's right, yeah. About 5 or 6 years ago.
What happened to your vision? Tell me.
Well, it happened within the space of like 2 or 3 weeks. I woke up one morning and one eye was a bit blurry, and I just thought, oh, yeah, nothing you know, put drops in it and everything. And then a week later, the other one went the same way. So I went to an eye specialist. Oh, yes, you've got glaucoma. Then they said, oh, no, it's not glaucoma. And then about 80 visits to the Ioni Hospital later, had surgery on my eyes, and now they haven't gotten it worse, but, yeah, I've got a guide dog as well. She
Have
comes
you?
Along to my shows now.
Yep.
And, yeah, it does, you know, does ruin your confidence a little bit.
But as I said in the intro, you've risen upon that now, or above that now.
Yes.
To a stage where you're back into everything,
That's
aren't
right,
you?
That's right, yep.
And I notice you love entertaining the seniors. You're getting around
That's
doing
right,
a lot
do
of that.
That's volunteer work.
Yeah.
A dementia care place.
Yep.
And that's how that's actually what got me back into it. I'd go there and they'd have people coming performing, and I was trying to get a normal job, which is pretty hard when you've got low vision. And one of the person who ran it said, why don't you try and get your own singing thing or going, you know, going around to places. And I just never thought anything of it. And then all of a sudden I thought, hang on, I might as well do that. So I recorded the demo, and then now I'm starting to get work, so I wouldn't mind some more work. But yeah.
Well, let's hope from this interview you might get more work today, and
yeah.
we'll be playing this through Facebook a little bit later on too. So I hope people do hear more about you and who you are and so on, because as you say, you sing a lot of jazz. There's
yes.
some beautiful old songs that you sing, and they're not just old songs. I mean, they're just fabulous songs.
Yeah, I love them. I love singing them.
And you seem to be re-recording all of the time, don't you? Updating things.
Yeah.
Why do you love music so much?
Why? That's a good question. I guess it's something that's in your blood, I suppose. You're born with it, you know.
Did you have parents or grandparents who perhaps were involved in a musical instrument or something?
No one.
So it skipped a generation, came out in you?
Yeah, it's just me. Yeah.
Isn't that wonderful? yeah. Have you ever taken on morning melodies and sung at places like the RSLs?
No, that's my next goal. I've only just started. It's only been 5 months since I started to get back into it.
Yep.
So it's early days yet, I hope. And I did a performance with a band last week, and they've asked me if I wanted to join them, and that's going to happen. So.
And what was that band, a local one?
They're called the Barn Band.
Right.
B-A-N-H. And they're a community band in Richmond.
Mm-hmm.
And we did a gig at the Commission Housing, and they've just asked me, they're thinking about doing a Harvest Festival. I don't know if you've heard of that.
Yep, I have.
Yeah, I didn't. I only just found out about that today. So I'll be doing that one as well. Just basically get myself out there.
I think that's it, isn't it, Barry?
That's right.
Once you get yourself out there and people start to hear you, they say, boy,
yes.
This guy's pretty good. I met you via Facebook and a mutual friend of ours got hold of some of your songs that you sent me. And then you'd ask me various things, and I was commenting on your songs yep. you were sending me. And I hear it getting better and better. And the way you're interpreting the words of the songs, it's just delightful. If you can't get a really full-time gig summer this year, I'll go here. I reckon there's something around the corner for you.
I hope so. I really do. That's my goal, just to be working full-time as a singer.
Oh, well, yeah. you can hear your passion in your voice.
Yeah, I just love singing.
There's a passion there, and because of that passion, I know that you'll get hold of that and do it. You would call yourself, what, a tenor singer?
It's hard to say. I don't know. Well, I've never had a lesson, so
yeah,
I don't really. Well, it's funny, when I went and rehearsed with this band, they said to me, what key do you sing in? And I said, what does that mean?
Barry, when you ask that question next time, say Z minor.
Yes, that's right. Yes.
Z minor, because anyone knows
laugh.
Z minor.
They laugh. I said, oh, hang on, I'll just start singing and you follow me.
That's the way to do it. That's the way to do it. Okay, strike up the band, boys. Just get the drums going and I'll sing to the
that's
drums.
Right. Yes. just do it, whatever.
Don't worry what key you're in. The drums will do it and I'll sing with them.
Yeah, that's right. Yes.
Well, if they're good musos, of course, they'll pick up you in C major or whatever.
Yeah.
That's...
It was almost like a jam session. I mean, we did one song and it went for 15, 20 minutes.
Isn't that fantastic?
Because I love I love you know, jazz scatting.
Yeah.
That's from Ella Fitzgerald.
Yeah.
Yeah. And Mel Torme. Yeah.
Well, there's a name, Mel Torme.
Yeah.
Yes. I've got a few of his CDs
fantastic
at home too.
Singer.
Oh, a wonderful singer.
Mm.
But to Ella Fitzgerald, you mentioned her a couple of times. I mean, to say what a delightful jazz artist she was.
Oh, she's just amazing.
So in your spare time, you've got the CD player going and Ella in the background, have you? Yeah. I can imagine you'd be doing those things.
Yeah.
And your headphones, walking down the street, there's Ella Fitzgerald with you.
Yeah, that's right.
What are you going to record next? Is there another song on the horizon?
I'm not sure yet. I have to, because I'm, you know, not really earning a lot of money doing it, I have to save up a bit of money first before I can do some more recording.
So you don't have a recording studio at home, you go elsewhere?
No. I just go to a place in Richmond.
Yeah. Okay. Well, what you have done has been very, very, very good, and I hope my listeners hone in on this and try and get you some invites perhaps to some of the Morning Melody programs around our region, other regions.
I've been told, recommended to do those, and that would be fantastic.
My word. And I hope the band, the Barn Band, takes off for you too, because once you're a singer with something like that, you do get heard, there's talent scouts around the place, and you'll be picked up all around.
That's right.
Have you got a Facebook page where our listeners can follow you at all?
Yes, I do. It's,
would you like to get that?
You have to. My name's a weird, a name where you've got to spell out both names.
Yep.
It's Barry, B-A-R-R-I-E, and then my initial J, my middle name, and then Trembert, T-R-E-M-B-E-A-R-T-H.
Yep. I once went to a school with a young chap when we were young. His name was Trembarth, B-A-T-H.
Oh, okay.
Trembarth.
It's pronounced Earth, as in Earth.
Birth, as in a ship birthing. So Barry J. Trembirth, and if you look him up, you'll get him on Facebook there. You'll hear some of his songs too, and you'll have the experience that I've had in meeting this young man too.
Like my page.
Yeah, my word. All the likes we can possibly get. Lovely to talk to you, Barry.
Thanks,
I wish
Lee.
You well in your future. Let's keep in touch, and we might have you back on again as time goes on too.
Thank you very much.
Good on you, pal. You take care, please.
Okay.
Have a lovely day. Bye-bye to you. It's 4 minutes to two. This is Barry. Take a listen to him.
Imagine there's no heaven. It's easy if you try. No hell below. Above us only sky. Imagine all the people living for today. Imagine there's no countries. It isn't hard to do. Nothing to kill or die for, and no religion too. Imagine all the people living life in peace. You may say I'm a dreamer, but I'm not the only one. I hope someday you'll join us, and the world will live as one. Imagine no possessions. Greed or hunger, a brotherhood of man. Imagine all the people sharing all the world. You may say I'm a dreamer, but I'm not the only one. I hope someday